Excuse us.
I thought you were waiting for David.
Maybe we should get some tape so we can make sure what we want on them. We'll get the tape.
Michelle, you never left your card. What's your name?
Did I forget? I wasn't doing card at 11 o'clock.
No, I thought you didn't get to.
Oh, I know. D. D here.
Michelle, please, who's here?
No, you don't have to write down. That's right, I forgot these people are coming. So you pretend like you're really listening, and I'll pretend like I'm really lecturing. Sir Walter Scott and Jane Austen. Now, that's a great test question, you know. Jane Austen and Sir Walter Scott were the early novel writers, but wrote mainly on British manners and mores.
Manners?
Manners, M-A-N-N-E-R-S, and mores, M-O-R-E-S.
They were what?
They were the early novels.
Who?
Jane Austen and Sir Walter Scott.
What they mainly write?
Mostly novels of British manners and mores. M-O-R-E-S. Sir Walter. Mores mean, society. M-O-R-E-S.
Yeah, he's gonna have some.
It's gone through this loop one time. Now it's going to come back on up here, and it's going to increment n by 1. So n will go to 2. Then it runs a test, n minus 7. 2 minus 7 is? Negative 5. Again, what kind of a number is this? Negative, so it's going to go back around your loop again. Now, rather than go through all these, you know, count through, let's simply say it. Next time, when I go through the loop, the third time n is going to be 3. And this would be negative 4. Now I should be, I've got the pattern going, don't we? We've got a pattern going, so let's simply set it up. So this would be 4, this would be negative 3, 5, negative 2, 6, negative 1, 7, 0. Now, at that point, maybe we need to decide. In other words, when it tests this at this point, n minus 7 is 0. How many times have we gone through that loop? 7 times. How many times do you want to go through? 8. Therefore, what is going to have to happen to one of these two numbers? J is also going to have to be 2. So let's replace J by 2. Now we'll go back through. It still needs to go back through the loop. At this point, then, it's going to increment n by 1. So therefore, j, or n, rather, will go to 8. N minus 1, 8 minus 1 is positive 1.
No.
Hi, I want to get a haircut like you do.
Smile, Dan.
Hi. Oh!
There, get a picture of mine.
No, this is not about pastime.
Get a picture of her picture.
Yeah, get a picture of my
picture. You gotta go
like this, though. Jansen!
Yeah, I mean, yeah, but the company. It is. Right there. Egypt.
It's a picture of Mikey.
Egypt.
Yeah.
Mikey.
What?
Bye. I think.
Bye. You guys have fun back yourself.
Can you play it now when it's your
little
heart? Yeah, I think it's fun.
Cougar Scout.
Can I see that? I'm kind of like, look in the camera you're looking at.
Response between which are really considered lines. And this Easter trope that was delivered was this. Between the angels, and imagine it would be some choir boys that have the line, "Whom seek ye in the tomb, O Christians?" And then there were three women that replied, playing Mary.
Concave shaping mirror has a radius of curvature of 30 centimeters when the face is 10 centimeters from the vertex of the mirror. What is the magnification of the image? Well, what we're going to have to do here is decide what case of concave mirrors we're dealing with. What case are we dealing with? Case 6. And that's where you get a magnification, a much larger image. Those of you who looked in this mirror, pass this mirror around, that's what you got. So we know the radius of curvature, so we'll know the focal length point. We know the object distance. Let's calculate the image distance, shall we? What's the focal length of the mirror? 15?
Yeah.
We'll do 1 over S sub I, right? So, we'll get here, common multiple will be 150.
You want to get that on film? Somebody may never say that to you again. We missed you, Mr. Bell.
Thank you. I'll keep this one. Oh, I can't. Smile.
How are you?
Good.
That's funny. You got wood there.
You know, I did, man. I'm good, bro.
Yeah, I'm
going to
share the lock with that. I'm going to get that.
But you do need to get this one last point down. Most people, most of us lay people, and critics would agree that the presentation of personal relationships, if you want to write that down word for word, most of us, whether it's reading just us average American people here, or the critics, that it is the presentation of the personal relationships. The presentation of the personal relationships that is the primary interest in a novel. And I want you to look, after you write that down, I want you to look at that and see if you agree with that.
Presentation of?
The presentation of personal relationships
is what?
Is the primary interest in either writing or reading a novel. The presentation of personal relationships that is of primary interest in either writing or reading a novel.
Okay.
Do you agree with that? Look at that. Don't you?
Going to circles. So let's start with the definition of a presentation. Make sure you get these enough, especially for those that are not familiar with the presentation. Some of you are going to get kind of bored with this if you've had all this before. That should make you feel great. This will be simple. You probably didn't get into permutations to the extent that you will. Underline the last two words, a definite order. People, we are concerned with the order that we're looking at. Yesterday on number 40, Mike put it on the board and showed how he used the multiplication principle. And people, hopefully what we can also realize is we are arranging six numbers in a row.
What happened in 1981-82 to the rest of the world when the United States had a recession?
Yeah. Well, when our dollar has dropped, but not gone as far as we would have bought as much other places, and they would have lost money.
Right. That's very simple. That's exactly what happened. When we had a recession, that means that our dollar value drops, does it not? Does that compute in your own mind, right? The dollar value drops. And then that means what as far as other countries buying our goods? Gee, it seems to me that if our dollar value is down, they'd be buying a whole lot of our things. Wouldn't they? I'm playing devil's advocate with you now. No, it doesn't work that way. Does it work the other way around then? If our dollar value is down and we're having a recession, that means that Americans aren't going to be buying as much, and therefore these other countries are not exporting as much to us. That's what Dan said, but does that compute well for you or not? Or is this too deep? I'm up to my knees in muck, economic muck, and I can't make any sense out of this. Would you repeat that, please?
Sure.
I don't mind.
Thank you.
probably zoomed in now. It's back now. Oh, it's not. She can't get both of them on.
You guys get them both in?
Tom, you want to move in a little bit this way?
Move in.
Move in a little bit that way, please.
Things will be fine.
Hey, da, hey, da, my puppy's back.
the house issue.
Let's go!
It's the establishing shot of the whole house.
I think you've got the trash can at the wrong spot.
You better come forward. Thank you. He's not ready yet. It's Bernhard Langer. Come on, Jack.
Or Dwayne Cole, whichever way you see it. This isn't baseball.
Come on, Jack. Let's go, Jackie boy. Wait,
I don't know.
Can you hit that thing or what?